I wonder if you can imagine what a kamikaze pigeon unit did.
Fly into things, fly into planes, engines.
You're getting there. It's a very complicated...
Fly down guns.
It's a mess.
Terrible nuisance to get out.
It was to fly at ships, but in a very particular way, inside a missile. It's got a window, right? Look, I'll explain it to you. Here's a pigeon. I've got a pigeon here. voila. Yeah. And I have a ship. Yeah. And you train the pigeon to peck at a ship. And every time it does, it's rewarded with grain. Then you put it inside its missile with a glass front, right? And a ship comes into view, but it's slightly on the left. Well, the pigeon's behavioural response is to peck towards where it is. Yeah. And this activates a relay. Yeah. And as it gets nearer the ship and it gets bigger and bigger, it pecks more and more and more and more and more, which tells them that they're on the right track. And they get really, really close and it explodes in a ball of flame. Destroying...
And that's the thanks it gets.
That's the thanks. It maybe gets showered with grain at the last second. As a thank you, who knows? But it's a guidance system.
Did it work?
It wasn't used.
Right.
But... what they did, using this man, Skinner, this behavioural psychologist's experiments, was they got a bit of glass, and instead of having a target on it or anything like that, it was just a plain piece of glass with an orange dot on it. And every time the pigeon hit the dot exactly like that, it would get rewarded. What, can you imagine why that would be useful?
I was thinking about this just the other day. It's funny you said it.
Very slow form of execution for someone. You put an orange dot on them.
You could the pigeon in the room.
You could activate 12 years.
No, pigeons have very good eyesight. And if an air rescue helicopter is searching the sea and someone's in a little orange dinghy or in an orange life jacket, the pigeon will always see it as a little dot in its screen. So let's go like that, thinking it's going to get fed. And that will alert the pilot. And it works. And that's beneficial and no one dies. Someone might even get saved.
Yes.
And then you eat the pigeon on the way back. The passenger pigeon, is that a familiar species to any of you? It's one of the saddest stories. There were flocks of them in America, and I'm not kidding, that were 1 mile wide and 300 miles long.
Good Lord.
They would have 2 billion of these birds. They were just the most extraordinary sight in nature, probably.
So they're shitting whole hills.
Yeah, absolutely.
If you're caught under that, you are dead.
You are. Seriously dead. In 1896, they killed the final flock of 250,000 in one day. Knowing it was the last American sportsman, and I use the word sport quite wrongly.
Did you know about the Puccini gun? The composer Puccini was a great shooter of birds, as a lot of Italians are. When I was in his house at Torre del Lago, there was the Puccini gun, which he made himself, and he'd be sitting there writing, you know, lovely opera, and he'd hear a snipe outside the window. He'd grab this thing, which had the bore on it like a drain pipe, and he could bring down 50 snipe in one go.
Oh, you see, is that sport? He's Italian. Italians, Americans, I mean, really. That's horrible. But can you imagine that? And then on one day, knowing you're wiping out an entire species to kill 250,000 birds in a day.
Did they know it was the last quarter of a million? And they sort of
thought, they knew.
Fantastic, let's finish them off.
Yeah.
That was the last flock, and then the last bird itself died in the Cincinnati Zoo in 1914. She was called Martha.
So the pigeons in Trafalgar Square, they're wild rock pigeons.
Wild rock doves.
Wild rock doves.
Yeah.
Do they know that? Because you don't tend to see them on the cliffs at Beachy Head.
They're confused by our rock cliffs, aren't they? That's the problem. Pablo Picasso was a keen pigeon fancier.
His father was a painter of pigeons. It was a style in late 19th century Malaga. Instead of, like, flower genre painting in France, whatever, his father was a pigioniana, or whatever it was called. And when he discovered how good his son was, he gave him his... brushes and never painted again.
Fantail pigeons he collected himself, and of course he called his daughter
Paloma,
which is of course Spanish for a dove or pigeon.
Indeed.
Una Paloma Blanca, you remember. There we are. So, B.F. Skinner was the name of the man who designed these missiles aimed by pigeons who were tapping in the nose, and it was tested successfully, but never actually saw action.
Thank you for watching. Do remember to subscribe to the QI channel and click here to watch more videos. Please, come on, pick something.